Hey guys, and welcome back to Knaveswell Farm. Now then, in today's episode, we are going to be buying a couple of bits of machinery. Now, off screen, I have in fact edited this version of the Land Rover Defender 90. I've taken the lights off of it, so flashing lights, logos, flashing lights off the front there, and given it a new paint job. The only issue is these mudguards. Now, in real life, they really don't come out that far. I've tried to change the actual 3D model of it in AutoCAD. However, when I try to re-import it again into Giant's Editor, it goes a bit messed up. And I think there is a Giant's Editor, an exporter for AutoCAD 2016, but I'm running 2017, so I can't actually use that. We're just gonna have to put up with them for now. However, it's a much nicer Land Rover, I think. Hopefully I got the reskin done correctly, because I remembered that in Photoshop I can do a color swap. So for example, all of the green on the outside at least should have been changed to this blue. Did that. Instead of this little tractor here, people would like me to get the Valtra. Now, should be able to afford that actually. I think we're going to get 15 grand from the Land Rover. It's not there, is it? No. 15 grand from the Land Rover. And I'm not entirely sure actually how much the Valtra is. However, we have got a bit of Fender, so we might add some of that in at some point. Along with the, whichever Fender it is we have. So, first off, what we have to do is return that tractor over there and also sell this Land Rover. Now, this Land Rover has been good to us. However, I thought, that was mainly for the snow plowing series, I think, really. With all the flashing lights on it, I've now got a pickup truck, so that can do that. So, we have that Land Rover. Now, jump in this. We got it on hire for 22 more minutes. So I'll put it and follow me. Now, I'm not entirely sure as well what else we can do this episode. Possibly another grass cut, actually, judging that. But if we do, we are probably going to end up buying the the butterfly mowers. Just because they work better for bigger areas. Example, I'm now running, how many grass fields is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no. 10, possibly, 10 grass fields. And to do that with a single mower, it's a bit of a pain, really. We are going to be changing out the mowers as well. Should have bought down on the back of this, really, if I was sensible, but I'll just sell it from back at the our farm. Return that. That's gone as well. So we have £321,000 right now. That will soon go down. Right, where are the mowers kept again? In there, yes. This single mower here, we are going to sell and get our bigger butterfly mower, really. So, there we go. And mowers, there we go. £52,000, that's okay. This means that we can get the fields done a lot faster as well, which is good. As well, sorry about there not being a video last week. I was on holiday and I forgot, well, I didn't have time to make a bunch of videos and upload them, really. Although, it could be a video of something I did there coming soon. Maybe. Not entirely sure yet. Right. Yeah, in fact, this episode we'll do some grass, I think. On auto tractor. Do some grass and then possibly get the voucher later. As well, I mean, how many tractors have we got? I think we got three tractors. To be honest, it's just us. We don't have a worker. The only time that we do get someone in to help is harvest. And we're not currently harvesting, so yes. If anything, they just drive the combine, actually. Right, hopefully a mower should be in here. Got delivered here. Now, actually, what we can do is we can cut 9 and 10. Because I could do with a bit more grass, really. Right, we've got, thinking about it, I've got a special mower that we can use with this tractor because, where are, oh, don't want to unfold that. Why is automatic help keep going off? How much is that mower? Because we might use that today. 50, that's alright, is that? I'm going to put 1 meter. You know what, we'll rent that for 2 hours. This mower is unbelievable, really. It's really quite cool to use, I think. Oh, I don't need to unfold them, actually, I don't think. This mower has a stand. Yes. Somewhere. So, instead of doing the normal thing, of driving normally, we are going to be doing a bit of reverse driving. Now, someone gave me a link to that mower to use with the Valtra. Unfortunately, the Valtra cannot do reverse driving. For example, this vent, we can actually turn the whole seat and steering wheel around and do it backwards. So that's what I'm doing today. Yeah, it's really quite cool, this mower, to use. I do like it. A bit of class equipment. It'd be nice if we could actually have a class that can handle this mower properly. But yeah. In fact, I believe in FS17 we are getting vouchers with reverse drive. I don't know if there's a technical name for that. That's what I think it is. Anyway. Yes, so hopefully that should be quite cool. And I think we're getting a mower like that as well. Not the same sort of style where it's all one thing. But at least it's, well, something different, isn't it? You know what, we'll do that field first, I think. It's a bit of can't speak today. Be a bit easier. So, oh, I thought there was a gate on here. That's a bit annoying because if this was my farm, probably take out the hedges and the fence, or at least those fence posts there and the grass, and turn it into one big field. Oh well, it seems to be this loud ringing noise from somewhere. I'm not sure what it is. Right, how much key is it to turn drive around on here? Only 9. Stored weights. Don't need weights. Change driving direction, that's it. So the whole guy turns around and now accelerating this is going forward. Or backwards, however you want it to be. So we will be using these class mowers. The correct way. Oh, not going there. be nice if we could sit forward a bit, I think. Because, well, yeah, I'd like to see the corner of that mower. Or at least have something sticking up off of there, so that I can see the corner. For example, I wouldn't want to go into the hedge there, because there's roots and branches and that, and it would mess my mower up. And it's not even mine, I got it, I'm hiring it today, so, yes. What's that? Is that just a empty bit in the field? Yep, that's good. Didn't want to be that. Didn't want that to be anything dangerous. Oh, I'll do that properly. Is it R? Yes. We'll go all the way up here actually, because we can. And then we'll end up doing a headland now actually, because you do a headland after you've driven all over it and all the grass will be flattened down. I think we'll do two headlands. It's probably a bit easier. What we can do is we'll just go straight down here, do a headland down here, come back up again, do another headland, and then we back in down, do another headland, and that should be it sorted. For headlands, anyway. Must be a bit odd, just if you're not, or if you don't really know about tractors or anything, just seeing this working in the field. People drive past, we think that's not meant to be doing that. Hello? Why is my door open? I know why. Apparently I've got to shut it. Without a doubt though, this mower is brilliant. I really enjoy using, look, I'd say it's quirky machinery. And thank you to whoever it was that gave me the link. I'll try find, you know, give a shout out sort of thing. But yeah, slightly disappointed that the Valtra doesn't do reverse drive. If it did, this mower would be perfect, because that hasn't got a front hitch, so this is why this mower was used, or was given to me. However, where the grass comes out the bottom, that would be facing the wrong way, so the mower would just, wouldn't work. Oh, wrong app there. YouTube Studio. We're actually getting this done fairly quickly, and I probably am going to head this just because it's a bit easier than not, and we need hay bales anyway. Well, apparently this past 28 days my channel has gone up 621 subscribers, so thank you to everyone who has subscribed. 56,816 views and 255,000 minutes watched. I don't know how many days that is, but I know it's a lot. Oh, I should have been watching a bit more, because I'm going to have to go back and do that again. Bit of it anyway. Alright, comment. Yeah, comment. There we go. As well, one comment that I keep getting is people asking if I will make a list of the mods. Now, I'd love to. Two reasons why I can't and I won't. First reason, I can't really track where all the mods come from. I Google that many things in a day, if I were to go back through history and, for example, this mower, I think that was 2 weeks ago, I'd be lucky if I found it. I can't track down where all the mods have come from, so I don't keep links for them. If I need something, I'll just Google it. Second reason, some of the websites are slightly dodgy that the mods come from. For example, my security software for my computer. Even if, for example, I go on Google Images and I'll look for a picture of the mod first, because I find that a bit easier. And it will say that some website is trying to access a computer, so it's blocked that website's IP address. And some of those websites are slightly dodgy, so I don't really want to give out links to websites which are dodgy like that. I don't want to be getting the blame for people having a terrible virus on their computer. To be honest, if you want a mod, the way I find the majority of them are is by Googling them. And if you, go through Google Images or something, or Bing Images, who uses Bing, I think they've got Bing Images or something, then you can actually find mods a bit easier. For example, this vent, I was trying to look for it, and I just went through Google Images. I think it must have been 30 images down, and then the correct version came up, and I downloaded that. Oh, cruise control doesn't work in backwards position, does it? Why are we using cruise control anyway? We can drive ourselves. So I'll do that other field now, and then we can get on and ted this next episode, I think. Now I'm gonna binge make a whole load of Knaveswell Farm episodes, because it's a bit confusing for people. A bit confusing myself when I'm looking through it to see which video I've uploaded and which ones need to go up. I've somehow managed to get both of these series to be the same episode number. For example, Knaveswell Farm, which is this map, why won't this mower go up? I've broken Farming Simulator. My keyboard's just died. That's annoying. Well, that's very odd. I was driving it as if I was going forward then, but I'm not. Oh, the keyboard's dead. This is going to look really messy now. Do I have any spare batteries? That's probably a no. For the purposes of this video being a success, you are going to see me do something a bit odd. I don't even have my iPad turned on either. As well, I think I might be doing a video on how to make an alternative games controller for example, Farming Simulator. I found this app called Touch OSC. Now, it's a MIDI controller. So, for example, DJs use it. And they'll connect, for example, quite a lot of DJs have Apple products, so they'll be running a Mac and a tractor or whichever DJ software it is. I found that, and there's an editor for it which can, I've made myself basically a touch controller sort of thing, an interface on my iPad. I did it where the keys are a keyboard key. because I went to, I tried to do F keys, but they just weren't working. It didn't recognise them in Farming Simulator, so I just had to do normal keys and numpad keys. It's okay for some stuff. So I've got PTO, which is B, I think, to turn on the machine. I've got that set to 1, and it's sort of like a little button. And any of you guys that have iPods and iPhone, iPad, something like that, it doesn't have to be one of the most up-to-date ones either. For example, my iPad, 5 or 6 years old now. And it still works. So there's an editor for the computer where you can add in buttons, LEDs and stuff to the interface. Now I'm only doing it with buttons at the moment, but for example I've labelled them PTO, fold, unfold, change implement, stuff like that. You click on it and it will do it, but you've got to have to make it work, you've got to have the editor on your computer, the bridge on your computer, you've got to know the IP address of your computer, because it does it through the network, and it's surprisingly quick actually, which is really quite nice, and it doesn't use a lot of battery either. So just stand it up on the desk and it just works as a nice interface. And once you've done the editing parts, you've created your interface, you put the IP address of your computer into the app on either iPhone or iPod, and you'll be able to find the computer and you'll be able to select the file which you want to transfer. I think it actually just does it by the computer. So for example, this computer could be called XYZ and come up with XYZ, and you would click on that, and that is how you transfer the files. So I've created a whole interface, drive control as well, it works well with that, but unfortunately numpad keys, like I said, don't work, so I had to do it with the normal keys. So I think I used to do shift 4, 5 and 6, so shift 4 would be 4 wheel drive, shift 5 would be front diff, shift 6 would be rear diff, and I've just got to do 6 and 5 and that keyboard don't work, so I can't show that. And for example, I was planning on getting the Satec, but looking at reviews, apparently it's not that good. It'd be nice to have the side panel. I've got a working steering wheel, pedals don't work for it though, so I broke them by accident, and part of it snapped. It's an alternative, and the app is free, SDK basically is free for the computer. It works really quite nicely. To say that it's meant to be a MIDI controller, because I did try looking to see if, because I knew it was a MIDI controller, I didn't realise it could do all the keyboard stuff. So I tried to look at how I could get MIDI inputs to work on the computer, like for example a game, and I've had no luck there with that. But then I was in the editor and I worked out that it can do keyboard inputs, so I did that and it works quite a lot. I don't really use it that often though. It's just a bit of a pain to have on a desk along with keyboard, mouse, steering wheel and that. I was planning on buying like a cheap £15-10 joystick for telehandler work. However, I'm going to try and experiment first, see if this Touch OSC can do controls. For example, I would like to get, I know that there is like a joystick kind of thing on it. So for people that are in the DJ industry, or like lighting and sound and that stage, You can have moving headlights, and they are controlled by joystick, and they are very fun to use, just mess about with at least. And that, it basically detects it as a MIDI device sometimes, so I'm pretty sure that's what that would be on TouchOSC. In fact, I don't think it is a MIDI device, it's its own XY axis, which it does it by, which is really quite cool. That's a bit of an issue as well. Keyboard's got no battery. I'll just shove some more in that. I'm now 25 minutes in. The episode's going to finish once I've finished this field off. But I've got no way of stopping the recording. Brilliant. Well, I've done this again, haven't I? Oh well. I do like these fields though, actually. It'd be nice if the cut grass texture wasn't as bright though, and it wasn't yellow underneath. I don't know, in real life it's more green than yellow. Or orange, I don't know what colour it is, really. Yeah. It's not really that colour. We are done. This tractor's gonna have to stay here. This episode will end with me in this tractor. The screenshot will be of me in this tractor. Yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. Really hope you have enjoyed this episode on Knaveswell Farm. There will be another one, or I will record another one straight after this. It's just a bit easier. I think after this, we are going to have four more episodes. That's 4 days worth of, well, not 4 days, it's 4 days that you get Knaveswell video, and then I'll start bringing back in Thornton, just so I can sort of catch up and separate the series a bit. They're both on episode 14, I think, 15. In fact, they're recording this episode 15 on Thornton goes out, I think. That'll be going out in 40 minutes. So yeah, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share this video, and I will catch you next time. Goodbye.